Hi everybody, welcome to Geomorphology 20030, so called because it's intended for students who are taking the module ESC 20030 with me. What I'm going to be doing in these sessions is giving you a very basic introduction to geomorphology that you can use to carry you through the rest of this module and also into your third year modules if you follow this topic through to that level. You're probably wondering why I've brought you into the shed to start talking about geomorphology, and it's because the first big point that I want to make about geomorphology is that a lot of what happens in geomorphology is straightforward, common sense mechanics of everyday things that you'll see in the world around you. If you think about the basics of geomorphology, it's erosion, transport, deposition. It's the impact of energy on materials. It's change in objects over the course of time. And a lot of those things you can demonstrate very easily in your kitchen, in your bathtub, in your workshop. For example, one of the starting points of geomorphology is the impact of energy on materials. In geomorphology, the energy comes from gravity or solar energy or a little bit of Earth interior energy. And that energy drives water, it drives the atmosphere, and it drives materials against materials. If you think about the waves eroding the coast, if you think about rocks in the base of the glacier eroding the substrate underneath them. If you want to see day-to-day examples of that all around you, where better, for example, a very straightforward illustration. So I applied energy to one material, the spinning head of the saw, transferred that onto another bit of material, and lo and behold, erosion. I've carved myself a valley or a gorge in there. What I've done is I've removed some of the material from here. Erosion involves not just impact, it involves impact removal. Removal involves transport. So the bits of wood that were there, well, they're now bits of sawdust. They've been transported and they can be deposited elsewhere. It's all common sense, everyday stuff. One of the big points of these sessions is I just want you to understand that geomorphology isn't difficult. There may be equations here and there, there might be a few numbers thrown in, but in order to understand how landscapes work, how landforms evolve, if you just understand some basics of energy impacting materials, erosion, transport, deposition, the movement of material from one location to another, you'll very quickly get a hang of the basics of geomorphology. And that's what we're going to be talking about over these next few sessions. I'm sure you're pleased to know that you're not going to be stuck in this shed for all of these sessions. It's really important to get out and look at the landscape. Andrew Gowdy said that it's the appreciation of great landscapes that draws a lot of people into geomorphology. And it's important at this stage that you have some landscape, some process, volcanoes, glaciers, rivers, coasts, that you're particularly interested in. And use that as a case study that you can use to apply to all the things that we're studying, all the general principles that we're getting out of these sessions, you can apply them to the particular case studies that you're really interested in. In other words, have some particular targets for your geomorphological curiosity. Now, as well as talking about the theory and getting out there and looking at the landscapes, the other thing that you need to do as part of these sessions is follow up the material that we're talking about with your own reading. For those of you who are doing this module with me at Kiel, there's lots of set reading available for you. And in particular, the basic textbook, if you like, or the basic book for these sessions is this Fundamentals of Geomorphology by Richard Huggett. We're not going to work slavishly through the textbook, but if you want to look up some background information and get some more detail on some of the things that I'm talking about, this is the book that I know you have access to. So before we move on, take some time out to make sure you can access the reading, and to make sure you've given some thought to what are your great landscapes, what are the landscapes that you're particularly interested in or particularly puzzled by, what do you find most exciting about geomorphology, what do you want to learn about? And then we'll move on and we'll get into some of the nuts and bolts of geomorphology, some of the mechanisms, some of the processes, and some of those great landscapes.